Yeah, the jaegerists. The boy wonder. Yeah. Yeah. Let's go. What's good, YouTube? Ghost of Gino back again with another Attack on Titan Season 4, Part 2 episode reaction. Today, people, today we are tapping in with Episode 2. Last episode, intro was a banger. The opening was some heat. I've been bumping it more times than I should have, probably. In terms of the episode itself, Eren is down with the hands. He's like, hey, Reiner's coming in, Porco's coming in, Peek is coming in, Commander Maggoth is coming in, General Maggoth. Bring in anybody who wants to work, they can catch it. 1v3, they were jumping Eren, but Eren was like, hey, I'ma handle y'all, until he got sniped by Peek from the corner. He was doing well until then, but rest assured, the rest of the Survey Corps are joining him. Mikasa's about to enter the battle. One thing to look out for, though, is I don't know what Yelena's up to, but hey, when Jacopon was talking about how Yelena did not keep him in the loops with anything, so I'm worried about Yelena. Attack on Titan, Season 4, Part 2, Episode 2. Let's hop into it. He's saying there's no way he could really switch sides. He's just playing both sides. The Braun family's like, hey, can we go back to the farm? Our work here is done. We're not urban. Did he just admit that? I love it, love it. Yes, sir. Understood the assignment. Let's go. Time to enter the field, man. The Survey Corps are about to enter the field. Let's go. Told y'all last episode, man. Don't let Mikasa enter the fray. Don't let Mikasa enter the fray. He was capping. Will we be free? Will we finally be free? That boy was distraught, man. He thought getting to the end of the island was enough, and then he realized you gotta go to the other side. I love Reiner's story, man. Is it over? Yeah! Eren said Uno reverse, my boy. Uno reverse. Who's that, Jaws? Yes, sir. Hard body. Hard body. He's trying to rip him off the nape. He's going to eat him. Shit. Not yet. It's not bedtime. It's not bedtime. Eren said it's not bedtime. What's going on? Yo, he ripped his armor. He ripped Reiner's armor, Matt. Oh, but then his face was not fully transformed. Anyway, that makes sense. Yeah, Eren's rage. Eren's rage. Abort the mission. Yeah. Bro, too strong. Too strong. Eren is on it. Oh, beast. Beast. Let's go, Zeke. Let's go, Zeke. Yeah, the jaegerists. The boy wonder. Yeah. Yeah. Let's go. Yeah. Let's go. Hey, I'm not tired of this OST. I'm bumping it from start to finish. You already know it's going to be a hype episode because my boy Zeke has just entered the battle. Let's go. Let's go. What are these floaty balloons to some rocks? They should have known we play baseball over here. Zeke, a.k.a. Shohei. Zeke, a.k.a. Fernando. Zeke, a.k.a. Jose Bautista. Come on, man. Yeah. Nice dodge. Okay, okay, Peek. Peek has some ability on her. Peek knows. Peek already knows. That's a specialty. Yeah, Flock. Yeah, Flock. The jaegerists are here and they're not playing around. They're not playing around. Rise, Eren. Let's go, Eren. What are we saying, Eren? Yeah, they don't really care about Eldians like that over there. Party without... Is that wise? Y'all going to the front lines when y'all can turn into titans at any time? Yeah! Bro, it's crazy. We started off with 10 cadets. And now it's just about 4. If you exclude Eren, it's about 4 because the others either died or switched to Marley. Well, they were always from Marley. Yelena! That's a trailer scene. That's a trailer scene. She's like, this is my plan. Look at her. She's in love. If she sees Zeke and Eren, bro, she's in love. Zeke is dealing damage. He's dealing damage. Yeah. Hey, I don't know if y'all can tell. I'm a jaegerist, bro. I've been a jaegerist, so let's go. Oh, Reiner's not done. Jeez, Zeke is hitting him hard. Damn. Whoa, what? Yo, what the fuck? That face. Bro, that face. Hold up. That's a rewind, alright? That's a rewind because the way that they drew her face, my guy, that was beautiful art. That was scary art. Armin is saying they should join the jaegerists, and she gives him like a look like, yo, what are you saying? Oh, God. Wow, bro. Hey, imagine waking up to that, bro. Imagine waking up to that. That's nightmares, bro. Yelena, suspicious. Damn, they got anti-Titan missiles. Okay, so Falco's out. Nah, Falco's got a good head on his shoulders. Oh, he told the truth. I forget his name. I think his name is Nick. He's a nice guy because him and Erwin used to be like, they grew up the ranks together. So I'm assuming he's either going to be smart and request a trade, or he's going to be like, yo, Falco, just go with your friends, bro. Facts. He just took the high road, man. Bro, guys like Nick, I think his name is Nick, either Nick or Klaus, guys like him and Erwin, bro, like they're higher people. Nile. Way off. But they're higher people, man. They don't care about this whole revenge shit. That's the Braun family. Perfect production. The moment Colt asks Gabby, why do you trust the enemy? Pans to the Braun family, who are the reason why Gabby kind of acclimated to Paradis. So Perfect production. Perfect production. Damn. Damn. Bro, is that an open bird cage? Bro, they're conveniently in like a bird cage store. What? Yo, damn. Talk to him. I knew it. That's real, man. Yo, Falco's a real one. Falco's certified, man. Jeez. Ayo, Beast is catching bodies. The Beast Titan is catching bodies. Let's go. This is so hype. Yo, what's that? Is that Peak? Oh, damn. She got out and maybe made a new one. Did she get killed? Oh, she got killed by Flock's team. I thought she shedded and made a new one. Yeah, bro, she shedded. Counterattack. Counterattack. Jeez! Damn! That's a direct hit. Arlie is fighting back, you know? Yelena's about to be like, yo, my god just fell. Damn. Oh. Yo, it's climaxing. The last person in the world who should have that power is you. Same words said in season 2. The OST's hidden. Bro, everybody is converging in the same spot. This is gonna be crazy. This is gonna be crazy, man. Holy. Yeah. Hey, episode 2 did not disappoint, bro. Zeke came in. Y'all already know Zeke is one of my favorite characters. This man came in and was like, hey, I'm taking all y'all out. Reiner, snipe. Porco, snipe. Peak, he thought he sniped. He thought him or Flock and his team would have, like, killed them. But then that's when, like, Peak shedded. Like, she basically, the thing that Eren used to do, goes out of her Titan body but keeps the Titan body there. So it looks like she's still there. And then they basically set up that anti-Titan machine and snipe Zeke in a one-shot. Zeke ain't dead, bro. Like, there's no way. Literally, I think the way they paneled it, it looks like his arm got hit, like his shoulder and arm. So I don't think he died from that initial shot, but they're trying to finish the kill in the next episode. So we're trying to make sure that doesn't happen because, yo, Ghost Vegino community, we are a jaegerist, man. Like, we are trying to see this thing go all the way to the end. Team Eren, Team Zeke. But yeah, this episode was crazy. One thing I want to talk about, though, Yelena. That girl Yelena. Onyekopone told us in episode 1 that she was crazy. You know, that she had not told the rest of the jaegerists about the plan between Zeke and Eren. And then now we see that the moment Zeke comes in, she's out here like, my guy, my God, you know, God, the God has arrived and everything. She's in love with that boy Zeke. We remember from season 3 when she was talking about, like, how Zeke rescued her and Onyekopone from, like, those countries that were defeated by Marley in the other wars. Bro, she got love for Zeke. When that boy got shot, hey, she was going crazy. But one thing I want to talk about, though, and I love the detail that the production did. Shout out to Mappa, the production on her face. Yo, when Armin is like, yo, guys, like, let's help out Zeke and Eren, fulfill their plan. Let's become, I don't think he said let's become jaegerists, but he was like, yo, let's help the jaegerists. Bro, Yelena was like, huh? like, she was looking at him like, bro, like, that's not what I want from you. But then she switched up and then she was like, please help save, like, Reiner and, please help save Eren and Zeke. There's something to be said about Yelena's initial face. There's a reason why they stress that. There's something fishy going on there. There's definitely something fishy going on there. I'm saying Yelena is suspect numero uno. You know what I'm saying? We got to watch our backs with Yelena. Next thing I want to talk about is the Marleans. The Marleans are making a comeback, man. They are fighting. They got weapons this time, bro. They got the anti-Titan weapon. They got float mobiles. I don't really, like, I know what to call them in French, but I don't know what to call the balloons that fly in the sky. I just call them float mobiles, bro. But they got those. They got four Titans. Three. Yeah, they got Jaws, Armor, Cart. They only got three Titans now. Damn, that's crazy. Because Beast is technically not with them no more. So they only got three Titans. But then they got a good set of people all over the place. Because you also have Gabby now. Gabby, who's finally coming to the realization that, yo, Eldians and Paradis are not devils, man. Same thing that Reiner went through. And Reiner came back conflicted. Literally built a bipolar disorder, split personality disorder because of that. Bro, Gabby's going through the same thing at a young age. So it'll be interesting to see what Gabby chooses to do. Is she going to switch sides? Is she going to start helping us? But I love, one thing I love about Attack on Titan, and it's why it is a goated series, top two, and it might not be number two, is that it touches on the reality that life is not black and white, bro. Life is not black and white. You could see anything from two different perspectives at any time. At any time. That's why we have politics. That's why we have different religions. That's why we have different mythologies. That's why we have different paradigms. That's why we have different everything. Because not everything is black and white. There's no fine print that says one thing is this and that's it. Unless we're defining like a word or something. Then there's like a clear-cut definition. Or if it's mathematics, then it's clear-cut. But in terms of life, in terms of ideologies, in terms of values, bro, there is never something so black and white, bro. You might see one side as a devil, but from the other side, they see you as a devil. And both sides have valid reasons to see you as a devil. Both sides have valid reasons to be like, yo, we gotta kill the other side. Eren is like, yo, y'all kept us in here for so long, I'm trying to kill the other side. The Eldians and Marley are like, yo, y'all are the reasons why Marley has us confined in here. We're trying to kill y'all. Y'all are the devils. It's so like, it's so twisted, but life is just never black and white like that. And Attack on Titan does a beautiful job of highlighting that in nearly every single episode. Shout out Isayama, goated. Shout out Mappa Production, goated. I love the detail in the animation. I already talked about Yelena's face, facial expression, but also kind of the CGI has gotten better. The fight scene. Bro, when Eren swung at a Porco and knocked the man out, he flew all across Shiganshina. Bro, the animation was crisp. That was CGI, but it was crisp. I think it was CGI. They might have made that animated that split second. But man, thoroughly enjoyable episode, man. This is a 9.5 out of 10 episode. If you guys enjoyed it, please make sure to leave a like, comment down below. Let me know your thoughts on 1, Yelena's facial expression. 2, Zeke, is he dead or not? 3, yo, things are escalating because now you have Mikasa, you have Armin, you have Jean coming to the fray. You have Gabby, Falco, Colt coming into the fray. You have Pixies, you have all those guys coming into the fray. And just a reminder, those guys are ticking Titan time bombs. You know what I'm saying? If Zeke decides to yell, hey, them boys are turning into Titans. So much going on, so much converging to Zeke and Eren. Because if they touch, we already know what they alluded to. The rumbling is going to activate, so hey, we're trying to make sure that it does happen, because remember, we are jaegerists, but everyone else is trying to make sure that does not happen. As always, if you guys are stopping by the channel for the first time, hit that subscribe button, join the Ghost Review community. We are jaegerists, but we also review other shows like Tokyo Revengers, Steins Gate Zero, all that good stuff. So hit that subscribe button, and yeah, it's been your boy Ghost Padrino, and I'll see y'all next time.